Good morning to all. I am Prema Sundari, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, NPR College of Engineering and Technology, Dindigul. Today we will see about the topic from Advanced Surveying, Third Year Civil Engineering. The code for the subject is GA8013. Today we will discuss about the topic from Unit 5 Miscellaneous, Road Surveying for Railways. In Road Surveying, having many stages in surveying for new railway line. First one, validation of new railway line construction. Next one, marking of tentative alignment. Next one, reconnaissance survey. In reconnaissance survey, having three types of survey: preliminary survey, final alignment survey. Next one, final survey report. First step, validation of new railway line construction. In viability of new railway line construction means, it is having 9 points. First one, to find out the total number of people living in the area across which a railway line is proposed or taken into account. First point is very, very important: total number of people living in the area. Second one, population habit and living standards, economic conditions. Third one, to record number of bridges, culverts, tunnels and topographical map of that area. Next one, fourth one, alignment and gradients, contour map of that area. Next one, connect all the industries by railway line and industrial map from the concerned department. Next one, it should not affect the very valuable land in agriculture. Must agricultural map to be studied to lay a new railway line. Next one, presence of agricultural land, natural industrial resources should be recorded. Next one is presence of religious places, a business center, market, etc. should be noted. Next one, amount of revenue and also accumulate passenger count, goods, etc. This is the first point, viability of new railway line construction. Next one, marketing of tentative alignment. Next one, second one, very, very important one, marking of tentative alignment. They are also having 9 steps. First one, a good alignment is always short and economical. Next one, amount of revenue. Next, minimum number of bridges, all culverts. Next one, earth filling requirement, filling and cutting requirement to be calculated, it is a minimum. Next, vertical curve should be eliminated. Next one, construction material and labor availability is as near as possible. Next one, it is easily reachable for passengers. Next one, cost of construction and expected revenue should be estimated along the good alignment. This is the second step for to lay a new railway line. It is this important step, marking of tentative alignment. Once the justification is shown to construct a new railway line, then the next step is marking of different alignment which are likely to support the new railway line. So must to study the following, the above points are discussed. Next one is reasons for laying a new railway line. First one, strategy consideration. Second one, linking of trade centers. Third one, connecting port with the interior of the country. Next one, shortening of existing route. Next one, laying of a branch line. Next one, undeveloped area. These are the points to laying a new railway line reasons. First one, strategy consideration. It become essential to join two points by a railway line for strategic purposes. So that is, in the case of emergency, and army can be transferred from one point to other point. Second one, linking of trade center. Train center means it is very very important one. Two trade centers may not be linked by up by a railway line. In such cases, a new railway line is proposed between two such trade center. Trade center means very very important places like to school to bus stand, or school to railway station, or college to railway station, or collector office to railway station. These are the important trade centers. Next one, connecting port with the interior of the country. It means a port is sometimes not connected with the interior of the country. In such cases, it becomes essential to have a new railway line joining the port and the trade centers of the interior of the country. In this point, we will discuss about the connecting port with the interior of the country. Next one, shortening existing route. This picture shows the clear cut about the point. In this picture, A, C, B. This is the existing route, long route. Propose a new route means A, C naught, B. In this existing route, give a shortened length for the railway line. So a route exists between two points, but if it is possible to shorten the existing route, a new railway line is to be laid. Next one, laying of a branch line. It becomes necessary sometimes to lay a branch line to an existing main line to develop certain other cities on the proposed branch line. The new branch line will serve as feeder line for the existing main railway line. Sometimes the engines may be crossed in the feeder line. Next one, undeveloped area. Once the railway line is laid to develop an area which may be rich in mineral resources or other natural wealth like timber resources. Next one is factors influencing the proposed road. Factors mean first cost, second one safety, next one speed. A cost should be minimum. It is composed of capital cost of the project, then maintenance cost. Next one is renewable expenditure. Next one, working expenditure. The cost mean it is composed of these are things. The route should be so selected as to bring the sum of all these costs to be minimum. Next one, safety. The safety means the available passenger and goods traffic should be transported safely. Then route should be so laid as to have minimum chances of train accidents. Then speed. Reasonable speed of train should be so selected. Then surveys. This is the third important points in the stages of a new railway line. Railway surveys, in order to have a proper and satisfactory new route, various surveys are carried out. First one, recognition survey. Second one, preliminary survey. Third one, location survey. In recognition survey, it is the first engineering survey. It is carried out in a tertiary which has not been previously surveyed for the purpose of laying a new railway line. The main object are as follows. First one, general knowledge of the whole tertiary and obtain information regarding the salient features of the tertiary. Next one, importance of recognition survey. First one, number of possible alternative routes between two points can be worked out. Next one, it is not a science, it is art. Next one, it is entirely depends on the personal qualities of the engineer, such as his training and experience, his capacity of observation and interpretation. This slide shows the recognition survey divided into two categories. First one, traffic recognition survey. Second one, engineering recognition survey. In traffic recognition survey, collect the information regarding the following. First one, general character of the country and the extent of cultivation. Second one, information regarding the local industries and religious festivals. Third one, population, density of population and people's locality and distribution of the population. Next one, the amount of traffic to be served by a new railway line. Next one, to join large trade centers. Next very important one, nature and volume of export and import and their destination. Next point, the amount of import and center of their distribution. Next one, development of industries as a result of the new railway line. Next point, visiting all trade centers and consultation with prominent citizens and local authorities regarding the most suitable route for the railway. Next one, standard of construction required for carrying the probable traffic. Next one, study of the existing means of transport. These are the points under the traffic reconnaissance survey. Second survey is engineering reconnaissance survey. Engineering reconnaissance survey, it consists of the following points. First one, physical features of the country. Next one, surface formation of the ground. Next one, nature of soil and its classification. The soil may be black cotton soil, river soil, clay soil, etc. The surface formation mean it is hard ground, soft ground, etc. Physical features mean it is flat surface or hilly surface or valley surface, etc. Next one, stream and river of the immediate vicinity, especially those which are likely to cross the proposed railway line. In stream and rivers means to construct the bridges along the stream and rivers. It is give a most cost of the survey. So avoid this area. Next one, position of hills and lakes. Next one, samples of water from well, river, etc. so as to ascertain whether the water is suitable for use in locomotive or not. Next one, availability of material and labor for use during construction. These are the points under the engineering reconnaissance survey. Next one, factors to be kept in view during the reconnaissance survey. The factors mean it have 7 factors. First one, area. Next one, existing road. Next one, starting of route. Next one, assumption. Fifth one, survey route. Next one, illusions. Next one, revenue. First one, area. A reconnaissance survey should be carried out for the whole area of the country. It should be never be carried out for a line only. Next one, existing road. The existing road should not be guided. Which is favorable for construction of road may not be used for the construction of a railway line. Third one, starting of route. The engineer should not reject a particular route simply because it starts badly. Next one, assumption. The assumption should be made very carefully, as sometimes they are likely to be proved wrong when tested by actual observation. Then survey route. Then illusion. Illusion mean most common estimation of wrong length of the line or offset. Next, wrong curvature. Next, overlap of hill may appear as a continuous ridge from a distance. Next one, revenue. Revenue mean cost. The probable revenue from the proposed railway line may be worked out. Next survey is preliminary survey. Preliminary survey mean the objective of the preliminary survey to conduct the survey work along the alternative route found out by reconnaissance survey, and then to determine with greater accuracy the cost of the railway line along these alternative routes. Next, importance of preliminary survey. It designed the final route and recommend only one particular route in preference to other alternative route, and then it depends on the alignment of the final route. Third one, location survey. The objective of the location survey is it is found and fixed as the most economical route from the data of the preliminary survey. The second point is the center line of the actual track to be laid. Then the location survey is completed, the construction work is started. These three surveys are very very important to lay a new railway line of the survey. Then in location survey having two stages. First one, paper location. Second one, field location. In paper location, the final route selected is put up on paper and details such as gradient, curve, contour, etc. are worked out. Then all the working drawings are prepared, even of minor structures such as signal cabins. Then after the paper location is over, the field work is started and the center line of the tracks is fixed. Next one, field location. The field location transfers paper location at the ground. It gives all the requirements of the construction engineer, such as benchmark, leveling, measurement, etc. The center line brakes are driven at every 300 meter intervals along the center line of the track. Next one, every change of direction, the beginning end of the curve and end of the curve and also intersecting point of the curve are clearly marked. Then to fixing the center line of the track and the center line of bridges, center line of culvert, tunnel, station building, signal gabions, etc. should be also fixed. These are the topics points. It is related to railway surveys to lay a new railway line. Today I take the topic from railway surveys, reason for laying a new railway line and factors influencing the proposed route, and then surveys related to railways. First one, recognition survey, preliminary survey, location survey. It is a very very important question in unit 5 miscellaneous topic advanced surveying for third year civil engineering students. In next class we will discuss about the route survey for highway and waterways. Thank you.